got together was because we had this, we had a similar taste in music and life in general, and the look is always just a mirror of that. And we liked a lot of bands like the Dolls and Motley Hoople, and well, Dolls was maybe the visual, mostly sort of gave us a lot of visual stuff, and Motley Hoople was musically maybe the biggest influence. So much of it was that all the five people had put their own personality into it, which together came out with the Hanoi Rocks sound or whatever. It was a mistake, really. It wasn't planned. A great band. Oh, you were big, weren't you? But we never sold any records. Then again, we sold a few afterwards to make up for it.
And all the things that we are doing, all the naughty things that we do.
Says, you know, like the old Hanoi Rocks manager says, oh God, if you were together, you'd be playing Wembley by now. And, look at what the Guns N' Roses boys are, you know, look, that could be you up there, whatever. It's hard to say where we would be. We might have split up anyway. But it was a bit of a strain on all of us. We were quite young, we were doing it, and we sort of just got thrown into the deep end. Well, we just jumped in, left Finland, where we all came from, into Sweden, then to England. And then we started to be on a sort of bigger stage. For us, it was a big stage. And we were playing to the whole world, and it was quite hard to handle. We would have either had to take a year off and then continue, or split up, I think, anyway.
I never picked a day. I never time you're away, I'm beating you. You know, I'm just so much in love with you. Please tell the Eggman.
Yes, indeed. The Hanoi legacy continues with Mike Monroe and now Nasty Suicide. After Hanoi split, Nasty released albums with the Cherry Bombs and as one half of the Suicide Twins, and has co-written songs with numerous famous rockers. In May 89, he formed Cheap and Nasty in Los Angeles.
We got it together really quick when we were in LA, when I went over there. I got together with Timo, who I'd played with before, and got Les on drums, and we had another bass player there, and it all clicked really quickly there quick enough to go and play a few shows around California. But then my 6 months was up, so I had to come back here. When I tried to re-enter the States, they said, well, they somehow found out that I've been playing shows and without a work permit. And I had more shows booked up, so they threw me in jail for the night and then back to here. So that put us back a bit. I thought that was the end, but then Timo and Les came over here. The bass player had a good job over there, so he didn't bother. Then I just found Alvin here. It's Alvin I've known for ages as well. So then, you know, when things have happened with this band, they happen really quickly, but then there's been this kind of 6 months to 12 months gaps, you know, and people are struggling with immigration and such.
The band members of Cheap and Nasty all have interesting backgrounds. Alvin was the bass guitarist with the UK Subs and Iggy Pop, writing, playing and touring with both bands. And Guns N' Roses recently played one of Alvin's songs, Down on the Farm, at the US Farm Aid Benefit concert, and they've recorded it for inclusion on their forthcoming album. Tino was formerly guitar technician for Hanoi Rocks and also played with the Cherry Bombs. He's recently co-written a song with Izzy from Guns N' Roses, which is also included on the new album. Drummer Les used to play for US rockers Cat House. He is in fact half Red Indian and was born and grew up on a reservation. Nasty explained to us how the influences of the four members make up the Cheap and Nasty sound.
Everybody's influences in this band come through, definitely. Our influences are more or less the same, but Alvin comes from he played in England during the punk days. I wasn't around here then yet, so he's got a bit more influence from that. And, well, Les has obviously got the Californian thing. I mean, he did grow up in Oregon, but he lived in California a long time, and he knows about that side of things. And Timo comes from the same place as me. But we really meet up nicely. We haven't had any disagreements about any, you know, anything really yet, which is quite amazing.
The band recorded their debut album, Beautiful Disaster, late last year. The title track is in fact the current single, but as we've played that recently, we're going to show you the first single, Mind Across the Ocean. Yes, Headbangers Ball bringing you right up to date with Cheap and Nasty. And if that type of music is not to your taste, stand by for the Metal Collection, when we'll be showing you some cover versions performed by thrash bands. See you.